DNA and polygraph evidence showing that she had actually been with her ex-boyfriend in Southern California, not kidnapped. Take a listen.
It's not like we don't know the answers to these questions.
And fear of Keith's reaction, obviously. The fear of all of these things are coming forward. They're coming now. The only way to get hold of it, the only way for everybody to come together and heal, the whole community has to heal, is for us to be able to say,
suggested he'll schedule a progress conference that may be held electronically so that voters from both sides will not have to appear in person.
Stay around, your news at 5 is just getting started. Coming up, a popular Senate retreat now looking to ban water bottles. Details on the plan assembly topo.
Plus, a push to register new voters, even ones with a criminal history, may be programmed in Guadalupe County. plus struggling homeowners caught up in what the government is now calling a sham operation. The local man was caught in another.
And it's setting the stage for realization now. The theater company is hoping to draw big crowds back to Sunrise Mall.
Well, I thought if I went to get you, you could have left for a car. So we, because she's not done till 7. So.
What happened? Why does it smell like bleach?
Go ahead, bleach my hands. Huh? My phone? Yeah. I thought it was 409.
Yeah, don't let it touch your
clothes. Why would you have it?
Huh?
Why would you have something with a bleach?
I use it to clean the island after we eat.
Bleach?
Yeah, to take all the germs off of it.
No thing.
Does this say it's a men's shirt? Does it look big enough for me? Yeah. No thing.
What did you do?
Thank you.
really exciting that the city is working with us and allowing us to be part of creating something brand new. So we're just excited just to see what we can offer to the community.
I was busy, so I didn't get to talk to him.
Benny, no. Don't do that.
Were you leaving to go outside when I took over?
No, I was checking him out.
Thank you. we want to get something to eat right before we go over there or drop the car off or what? Does it just cake and ice cream?
Take him for around the block real quick. You know what I'm recording that, so don't need it anymore.
Thank you. Earth Day.
The number of homeless
homeless people in Yolo County has climbed since the pandemic. Did county announce the results of its February point-in-time count, finding nearly 750 people who identified as homeless there. That's a nearly 14% increase from the last count back in 2019. The county says the number of homeless people not living in a shelter is actually down about 5%. Also in Yolo County, the push to get out the vote. The election office is launching a campaign to encourage those with criminal histories to register.
So you're still too sure to get past the order to vote for.
Tim Rogers almost didn't register to vote. Until he saw Yolo County holding a voter registration drive in West Sacramento. At 15, he entered incarceration. He's never voted.
So it is important for those who have been part of this legal system to know that they have the ability to register.
Voting advocates also say Californians who are being supervised by probation or parole or serving a jail sentence are eligible to vote. An exception is for anyone currently incarcerated due to a felony. The Center for Inclusive Democracy released a report highlighting the barriers formerly incarcerated people face in the state.
You
He wanted to drop a car off over at the school. You left the pork chop in the microwave all night. So I had to throw it out this morning. Right, well, I'll go head over there. You meet me over there? The high school. Isn't that where their practice is? And then I can drop the key off in her bag.
Thank you.
Where's mine?
I ordered it.
Very heavy. Channel 10, my show.
This like.
We've got like 5 minutes.
You need like
8 o'clock. There's a lot of meat on this taco.
Ben, seriously?
She's like, yeah. Because I do it every day.
Ew, don't I so excited. You better breathe. And we have a better shot than before it's going to be.
Who said you don't have a shot?
I see.
Well, they beat the senior roster.
Last year, they didn't have anyone but Kylie. They just blocked Kylie.
That would have been an enforcer right there.
Yeah. But not stuck in the mirror.
She would have loved it. She'd get physical.
Yeah. We can't really get two tackles in the
mirror. Well, Martine said that they're having real, like, refs.
Oh.
They have real refs and then Feather and Amador. I like the advisor. So fun. Why is the secret right here? Me and the QB locked in like this.
Who's the quarterback?
Really good thing. She should be best friends with Mr. Bacon. It's so funny. My goat is like, I'm screaming for it. He said he hasn't seen Bowser with Evan, but he said, we've been like the most enthusiastic team in like 20 years.
You guys, your team?
Yeah, because we were like, getting to the Prince Archimedes, so we were like getting together, our team and their team. So we were like, heck a chance, so we were like, Mom, I just get closer
to the food. I would eat over there if I didn't have someone like right up in my grill.
They're talking about a dad, not me.
Maybe tonight, Tina, they convince
Rachel that his
indiscretions were just a momentary lapse of judgment.
Indiscretions. Maybe Eric can explain
Please welcome Gabby and Rachel.
Go away. Her dad's even getting excited about it.
Oh, yeah. I just knew you were gonna complain you can't hear it.
What is she wearing?
What the heck?
It's so great seeing you both here tonight. Time flies. It was just 7 days ago that we were all here on this stage together, and then here we are. We're gonna see the final moments of your journey as bachelorettes come to an end. Hope you play out for the live audience. How you both feel tonight?
Thank God.
Yeah.
We're ready for it.
We're ready.
Your dress ripped?
I mean, we've come such a long way, so I think we're ready for everyone to see how this all plays out.
Okay, we don't go anywhere because we do have a lot to get to tonight. Let's begin this thing. The Bachelorette finale starts right now.
Well, look up.
The other guy, Gabby's guy, wants to just date her. Doesn't want to get an engagement yet.
It could be the most dramatic season ever. And we're going to get to it all when the Bachelorette season finale returns.
Before the Empire ruled the galaxy. So the guy that basically called that didn't end up going to the fantasy suite, or they did, but it didn't work out.
Yeah.
He's the next bachelor.
You already know that?
All out on social media.
Well, good, all right, Hoshin.
Down.
I came here to find love, but instead I have a best friend, Senor Snuffles.
Do you still have this girlfriend?
Will you accept this moment as a symbol of my love?
Sure, the place where you he had to go get a TB test or something, or physical. He said they offered him a job. Physical, physical therapist assistant.
He's an athletic kid. Probably understands, you know, athletes.
He got a bachelor's. He, they're like.
But nowadays, the bachelors can't really get to a whole lot.
That's kind of like we're talking about. You talking about if you like one of the last guys you talking about you want to date? That's just like a big hit because she could have said, "I want to date after this. I don't want to marry nobody. I want to date five guys and see which. I just want to date."
Yesterday, Eamon and I did break up, to be honest.
felt so strongly for him, and those feelings don't just go away really quickly. But at the end of the day, I know where my heart is. And it just is Gino. Hello. I can't wait to tell him that
he is out down here. Man. You really need to.
I'm excited about her.
Cheers. Grandma said, she said something to you and you didn't get a call?
Can you blow this?
Did she get the gift I gave her?
Your family was the one I just got? Love it hard? Is it a gift? Or was it just
things? How'd
you feel about it?
It went really, really well. Like, I just really don't think it could have gone better, which just gives me so much more confidence, I think, coming off of having such an incredible overnight with you. And
get down!
Because
get
down! It's really important for me that they all see what I see in you. And I know they not only saw that, but they could really see just everything beyond this, and I think we would be a pretty good match.
A pretty good.
So speaking of that, how are you feeling about everything?
Amazing.
Still amazing. Huge.
Much. And I say at times this was a really hard way for us to find each other, but you know, I wouldn't change a single second of it.
Me either.
Made for me.
I feel like you truly are my perfect match. My family and friends said the same thing.
And literally everyone.
And
divorce
you
in 2 years.
Are the only one here.
Why are you talking like that?
You are the only one here.
Me too.
Like, dang it! You're like, dang it, I don't have no cop out now.
No, but I can the editor. Now I can drop the bomb show.
The best thing I think I've ever heard. You're just waiting to have a second. That would literally bet everything I have and everything I am that me and Rachel are forever. I just want you to know that she's never going anywhere.
I just feel so happy right now. Tino has told me so many times that he is ready for a proposal and doesn't want to be without me. And that's an amazing feeling, and I trust him.
Lies.
To this point, it really seems like all signs are pointing towards love for you two. But will it stay that way? That is the big question. We're going to find that out later. But first, are you ready for more Kardashians? We've got an exclusive first look at season 2 on Hulu. This Thursday, September 22nd. And here is going to be something everybody's talking about.
Something that I'm ready to talk about. Tristan and I are having another baby. It's supposed to be a really exciting time, and it's just a different experience. It's hard to watch her in pain. This has been a difficult time in my life, but it's the start of something positive and happy and beautiful.
They get into those situations.
She lost a lot of weight.
Huh?
She lost a lot of weight.
If you want to lose weight, Weight Watchers is ready for you. Meet Google Pixel
Pixel 6a, the smarter phone that can see in the dark with night sight, fix your photos with Magic Eraser, and photograph all skin tones accurately with Realtone, Google Pixel 6a. Save up to $150 on an unlocked Pixel 6a with qualified activation.
JC tried Game Flings for the first time the other day. The scent made quite an impression. It was like that tower and JC were the only two left on Earth. But they weren't. You can always spot a first timer. Game Flings with Oxy Boost and Febreze. Seriously good scent. And now, get $10 back when you spend $30. That's a seriously good deal.
Any questions, Chris?
All good. Thanks, Mom. There you go. One deal in hand.
Nice. Do you get my refill, too?
Maybe.
Healthier is awesome.
You can't even do it. You've been back for
it. She's
in back for
it. Alaska Day miniseries premiere October 6th on ABC.
Owning a house is big. Bigger than loans and down payments. It's an oasis. A restaurant. A cinema. It's home. At Golden One, we get it. Big or small, we work with you to reach your goals. And as a not-for-profit credit union, we'll help you find better loans and rates. So owning your home is more possible than ever. So join us. Let's make your dream home happen.
Another busy day? Of course. You're a CIO in 2022, but you're ready because you've got the next generation of global secure networking from Comcast Business and fully integrated solutions all in one place. So you're covered on-premise and in the cloud. You can run things the way you want. Your team, ours, or mix of all. With the nation's largest
sit.
And most innovative company. Bring on today the Comcast Business. Power and possibilities.
I'm Janine Teets from Philadelphia.
Girl, you already know who you are. Get to it.
People think school starts when the kids get here, but it starts at development week. It's the calm before the storm. It's very zen, actually.
Studied studio audience. That's right. All right, now you two, you really did make history when we announced both of you as being the Bachelors. I feel like so much has happened since that day. Does this feel like a lifetime ago to you when we made that announcement?
It does, yeah.
Definitely yeah. Hold that and put through the ring.
Thank you, Memphis.
We're on a point of the journey now where, I mean, it's down to your final guys. One final day. And listen, no matter what happens here, all of America is rooting for you and your happiness. Are you ready? Here we go.
Why are you on your phone watching your favorite show?
To decide on you. He tells me every single second. Like, he tells me I love you, like, every past second. I love you. I love you. And it's
oh
just
my
like,
God.
It's insane to really feel like 100% chosen and fought for. I've never
what?
Had someone like, love me and show me love the way
you need water
has,
too.
Like, he makes me want to
go. You can get the water.
Like, he's just so selfless and just giving and. Like, he just is my perfect match. Like, I have no
idea.
I can't believe that I can't.
Oh my God.
So that's where I'm at.
Oh my gosh.
I'm dying.
Okay. So, Eric is the only one here.
So he knows he's the only one here?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Because I wanted this week to be, like, us being really secure and, like, making a decision to be engaged. And fought for me, fought for me time and time and time again. Like, I've never had someone love me as, like, willing and easy as them. So I think we're both willing to, like, jump together at this point.
And he said he's gonna propose.
I mean, he didn't really say it, but like, I hope so.
I heard you can see
though. Yeah. Are you so excited?
So excited. I'm so ready. I just don't have a doubt. Like, I truly, if it's not him, I do not know who it could be.
Yeah.
I'm so happy.
Yeah.
You seem so happy.
Yeah. I
like, yeah. Like, yeah. Yeah. Chris. Yeah. Like.
I think it's like essentially.
I think if I don't plan on going anywhere on Saturday, I'm going to watch Omari.
Yeah.
March in the band.
So, like, I cannot
huh?
I can't really came from.
That's great.
That's where we're sitting right now. And,
I'm
trying to
watch you guys.
Your dream.
I'm not
sure. I never said that the last time that we're engaged, it worked.
What did you guys work on today?
Eric loves you so much. I'm so happy. Riles,
we played more like a scrim
match. Riles.
Sorry. But
you
are fair. And our options and
fast break.
Yeah, fast break option. And then we did more of like a scrimmage.
Wait,
how'd that go?
I feel so lucky.
Look good. Our team's good.
I've been
expecting
how far
the,
I've been.
The bear is okay?
Yeah, for us. People still aren't here.
For you guys?
And then
who's having a hard time?
And they could be the beginning of the rest of my life. He's never given me any reason to doubt him.
Something.
But no matter what, you still do have that little bit
of. Was
it
Alexi there?
Yeah.
This is everyone was there, really big stuff. I mean, he says he's ready for an engagement, but it is kind of looking him in the face at this point, and I think people can get scared.
I just think this entire journey, every single day I've been nervous and waiting for something bad to happen. It's just really scary because I'm so in love with him. Like, it isn't even like,
so in love, come on. You just was all shook up over that other dude. Look at Pops like.
Amazing.
That was so fun.
So excited.
Oh, they're blonde.
I'm so nervous right now. But I'm so excited. I truly feel like right now it just doesn't feel real.
It's not. Yeah.
Thinking about night one and your charm and humor and everything about you was just undeniable. And I need you to know that I truly have never met anyone in my life like you.
He tricked me.
Someone who's just so selfless and gentle and supportive and
tricked
makes me.
Me
want to be a better person every single day. This
mother
journey has been so hard for me.
Like
there were times when I didn't think anyone was here for me and I didn't feel deserving at all of this role I was given. But I would do it all again a million times to be having you in front of me right now. I don't feel like I could be happier than I am in this moment because I'm so madly in love with you. And I cannot wait to spend the rest of my life.
So I bet you he proposes and then something happens after.
I know you've been blindsided in the past. You've seen love given and taken away. And with everything we've been through, the last thing I wanted to ever do is break your heart. But there's something I gotta say.
Damn.
This is never going away.
Something happened.
The first night, I was more nervous than I ever have been in my life. And the second I grabbed your hand to take you to the stairs, magically, effortlessly, you made me feel calm and confident. And now I'm standing here on the biggest day of my life. And yet again, you make me feel so confident. I know I've said in the past, like, I'm not the most spiritual guy, but this journey really did make me believe in fate. You're the most beautiful woman in the world. Your compassion, your wit, your charm, your intelligence make me fall in love with you more and more every time I see you. Every time we're together, you make me feel like the center of your universe. And I'm here today to show you the center of mine. This crazy love is gonna look too good to be true to some people, but it's as real as it can be. And quite frankly, the only person I care about understanding that is standing right in front of me right now. You, Rachel, I love you so much, and I'm gonna love you till the end of time. And you make me feel so loved and valued and appreciated that I want to dedicate the rest of my life to making you feel cherished and loved the way you deserve. I'm so hopelessly in love with you. You're the woman of my dreams. And there's really only one more question to ask. Rachel Radke, I'll spend the rest of my life with you.
You are my everything. I love you.
Thank you.
for a while. You remember that day like it was yesterday, Rachel? You looked so beautiful. You were so happy. And you were just glowing. That beautiful Neil Lane brand on your finger. Mm-hmm. But watching your facial expression, seeing that video, I can tell that this isn't the end of the story between you and Tina. Okay. When we return, you're going to witness something that you've never seen before, ever. Might need a glass of wine for this one. Don't go anywhere.
Okay, I got it. I got my wine, Finn.
Someone upgraded.
At least when David's age appropriate, prepare for a battle.
There you go.
It's all perfect apart.
You can't believe it. Go.
I'm good. Thanks. It is.
Which one?
This one will.
I see two.
Please stop doing that.
Ticket to Paradise in 2015.
Meet the 4-year-old who refused to wear pants this morning. Why, Andy?
I'm a dinosaur.
Won't wear pants. Won't eat Eggo waffles. Get your wings where you can. When you Lego, with it. Eggo. Ziploc is designed to store fresh dumplings, so you can unlock long-distance traditions. Ziploc, unlock life. America's number one trusted food storage bag. S.C. Johnson.
You got KFC, mijo?
This drum and thigh combo is only $6.
Good deal.
For you.
But you bring nothing home for your abuelita.
You okay?
No.
Get your own $6 two-piece combo at KFC.
My moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. The itching. The burning.
My skin was no longer mine.
Emerge Tremfyat. With Tremfyat, most people saw 90% clear skin at 16 weeks. The majority of people saw 90% clear skin even at 5 years. Tremfyat is the first medication of its kind, also approved for adults with active psoriatic arthritis. And it's 6 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Serious allergic reactions may occur. Tremfyat may increase your risk of infections and lower your ability to fight them. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, or if you had a vaccine or plan to.
Emerge Tremfyat with Tremfya. Ask your doctor about Tremfya today.
With Canva, we brainstorm together on whiteboards.
We all bring brain power.
Ooh, to bounce off each other. For the best ideas, what will you design today? Start designing for free at canva.com.
The Goldbergs are back.
What the heck?
As a new season is born.
Do you know what nesting is?
I pushed 3 perfect babies out of my...
I'm in the room.
Jeff, you gotta stop making everything so weird.
Season premiere, ABC Wednesday, and stream on Hulu.
We're going to Disneyland. To infinity and beyond.
That's our words, but all out.
This is, of course, the live finale that you've all been waiting for, and I'm here now with Rachel, and we just watched Tino propose, and of course, she accepted. And what a beautiful moment that appeared to be. But Rachel, when I was watching you watch the video, you could barely bring yourself to watch that back, so I know that there's a lot more to the story. So catch us up finally on everything that's happened between both you and Tino since that magical day in Mexico.
Yeah, I mean, obviously there's a lot of emotions watching that. I remember exactly how I felt. I truly felt like I had found my person. I was like really done. I was excited to leave and leaving Mexico with the hope for like the future. And I mean, it was really great for a while. I think every single bachelorette, bachelor that's ever sat on this couch knows that when you leave, there are just natural growing pains in your relationship. I mean, you're dating long distance, you're getting to know each other better, and it's difficult. We went through a difficult time. I mean, that just comes with having your life on screen. And around the time of the premiere, we just started going through a difficult time. I mean, when you put your entire life for everyone to see and judge, it's definitely difficult. I'm not saying I'm perfect. I've made more than enough mistakes, and I'll be the first to admit it. And we definitely had some difficulties in our relationship, but throughout it all, I feel like I always tried. And that's all I wanted out of a partner, was someone who was just going to stand next to me and support me.
Right.
And around that time, I just wasn't feeling that support. And if I'm not feeling it, I mean, I probably wasn't giving it as well. And, you know, we took some time and tried to figure out how to move forward. And for the most part, I thought we had. And we were at such a great place, again, kind of moving even farther beyond where I thought we could be sitting on this couch today. But it didn't turn out that way.
So then what happened?
Around a couple weeks after, we had some difficulty after things had started getting better. He brought forward to me some concerns about maybe relationships from the past coming forward and alluding to certain things. And I told him, you know, if it happened in the past, let's talk it through. Let's get, you know, past it. And he didn't really want to tell me. We spent the rest of the week together, and when I got home, I got a phone call from him, again, alluding to previous relationships and things coming to light. And I slowly was pulling on that string and revealing more and more. And, I mean, I think everyone knows, obviously, didn't really work out. He cheated on me.
I'm so sorry to hear you say that. Are you doing okay?
No.
I can't imagine how devastating that must have been to hear that. What was your reaction when he told you he cheated on you?
I mean, it's just heartbreaking. This is the person I thought I was going to spend the rest of my life with and start a family with. And we went through difficult times, but every single relationship has to build on that. You can't really just leave it when there's a bit of a crack in the glass. And it's not just physical, it's emotional, it's texting, it's so many things that come together and just pile on. And I mean, it's just broken trust at the end of the day. And it's just really heartbreaking to watch back and have to live.
Again, I am so, so sorry. I know that you were looking for happiness and love at the end of all this. I can see you're getting emotional now just having to relive it. I know this is not what you deserve. It's not what you were expecting at the end of all this. Now, you did confront Tino in person to talk about all this, right?
I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're going to show you at home now that conversation they had. And I do want to warn you, Bachelor Nation, this is rough. But this is what happened. Here we go.
This is rough. What's your friend doing, man? Who he's looking at?
Today will be the first time I speak to Tino since he told me that he cheated on me. I really do feel like I don't know the full truth. And so I just called Gabby immediately, and then I was like, Tino just cheated on me. You need some.